Okay, so here we have some scrap hardwood that I had laying around the shop. This is cherry, and this is walnut. This is actually an extra leg piece that I made for that ping pong table job. And then over here I've got some hard maple, and then some cherry cutoffs, probably from cutting boards or tables. So I'm making toy cars. I've got a car design and a truck design, and these are the wheels that I'm going to use. These are actually the rubber feet that I'm selling as cutting board feet, so I'm multi-purposing them to be my tires for my toy cars, and they're going to work really good. So this is for the cars, and then this is for the truck. So I got two designs, two different size tires. And so this is a test product. I haven't made these yet, so this is a prototype run of my toy cars and trucks. So here's a quick rundown of the tools that you're going to need before I start this project. You're going to need a drill press, and to make the cars I use a 13/16 drill bit. This is a Forstner bit, and it's not a common size to get the 16ths in your Forstner bit sets, so that's an uncommon size, but it seemed to work for this size tire. Then for the trucks, I have an 1 1/8 Forstner bit, which is a standard size, and I'll be using that for the wheel wells of the trucks. So you definitely need a drill press to operate these kind of bits. And I have my drill press over here. It's kind of a mammoth old school drill press, but it's very sturdy. I like using it. And another machine tool that you absolutely need is a table saw, and specifically a table saw with a cross cutting sled like this, because I need to make some very careful and accurate cross cuts to cut the slots to hold the axles. And just making the parts as well, you need a cross-cutting sled because it's difficult to handle small parts on the chop saw. So that's one of the advantages of the cross-cutting sled, is that you can get a little bit closer to the blade and it's easier to secure the workpiece to the sled. So, but other than that, the project is relatively straightforward. For sanding, I use these sanding blocks that I make out of PSA-backed sandpaper. So I'll use these to clean up the tool marks and smooth out the product, get it ready for finishing so it's not so rough. And I also use my edge sander, which is over here. I can do some of the finished shaping and contours of the parts on this machine, even though it's a much bigger machine than it needs to be for working with small parts. I can still get pretty good control. And I actually have a 220 and a 320 belt that I can put on this, so I can get a very polished, clean cut on this machine. But you could also use a belt sander the same way. You can put a fine grit belt on your belt sander and clamp it to your workbench, and you can do some contouring and shaping freehand that way. But those are all the tools that you're going to need to make these parts, besides some glue and clamps. I think I have enough clamps. All right, so let's get started. Let's make some toy cars and trucks. Okay, so I'm about 3/4 of the way through the milling process, and now I'm going to change gears and complete some other steps. So to explain what I've done, I've surfaced 3 sides on the joiner. So I start with one flat side and then do one 90 degree corner, and then I do a rip on the table saw and I just leave it a little bit big, and then I go back to the joiner to finish the other side. And I do that extra step on the joiner just to minimize sanding that I would have to do later on to eliminate all the saw marks that are left over from the table saw. So it's an extra step I do with the machining on the joiner, but ultimately it will save time when I sand the piece. So what I'm going to do now is drill the holes for the wheel wells, taking advantage of these pieces that are thick, because I need a little bit of extra material to guide in the center of the drill bit. So otherwise that makes that drill operation a lot more complicated, and I'll get a cleaner cut if I have enough material to guide in the center of the bit. So I'm going to drill the wheel wells in this piece of maple, referencing off the side that I finished on the joiner. So some of these edges that are not joined I marked with X's just so I can keep track of which sides I ran through the joiner already to make sure that I reference off the straight sides. So another note, the parts that are going to hold these wheel axles, they need to be fitting in here like so, so that there's just a little tiny bit of play so it's not fitting too tight. But this finished dimension has to reference this prototype axle assembly. And that has to be done ahead of time. So before I go to the drill press, I'm going to do some finished cross cuts on some of these pieces using my table saw sled, because some of these ends are rough, and I'm going to reference off the ends when I set up my drill press. So I'm going to do one last step in the milling process. Okay, so I made a slight mistake here. I forgot to make all my holes for four truck bodies. So I can get four trucks out of this one piece. I only made holes for two of them. I was going to cut this board in half, but I forgot to do it. So I'm gluing this glue block on just as a safety measure, because that makes drilling the holes safer, because I could make this cut on the drill press, because I cut the center of where the drill bit enters off, so it's just making this partial cut. So I can't make that freehand. I can clamp it on to secure it and then make that cut, but it usually doesn't end up very clean when I do that, so I like to just glue on the extra piece and make that cut safer, and then I'll cut this in half, make my other holes, and then I will just cut off this glue block when I'm all done. Thank you.